another round of drinks. But these beers aren't for drinking. Twice a week, these scientists in Belgium partake in a blind testing of about 8 different beers. With each sip and sniff, they're analysing the subtle differences between beverages.
It's a pretty technical tasting. The idea is not to get drunk, to really figure out which chemicals are in there, how the taste is, and really compare it. And it's actually quite difficult to do a scientific, almost mathematical tasting.
They're working to characterize some 250 Belgian beers and build a scientific map of beer to help drinkers select their next tipple. But a drinkers database isn't the only focus for these self-proclaimed beer geeks. They're also using genetics to make better beer. Brewers in centuries past reused the best yeast over and over again for their beer, even though they had no knowledge of genetics. It's the same principle here, only on a much larger scale.
Using some of the latest technology to make even better yeast. We're, for example, using robots to cross different yeasts, making millions of new strains or variants of yeast and testing which ones are the better ones.
Well-known brewers are already working with the team here to tweak the formula for their beers to, say, eliminate a particular aroma or aftertaste. They currently have around 30,000 new strains of yeast, some of which are genetically modified. While GM beer isn't a popular idea, these particular yeast strains could have other benefits.
Biofuel industry or in the pharmaceutical industry, genetic modification is a great way to make yeast produce certain chemicals, certain medicine.
There's plenty more work and beer to keep the researchers busy. But with no hiccups along the way, they're confident of success in their quest for the perfect beer. What goes into a horse?